for the revelation that God has for us tonight. Hebrews 35, chapter 10, verse 35. Did you find it? Give a shout to the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Tell the neighbor that's next to you, tell him, I'm in the right place with the right person. Tell him out loud, say, I'm in the right place and I'm in the right person. Say to me, say it, Holy Ghost, you're welcome. Yeah, hell, Holy Ghost, make yourself at home. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, verse 35, so do not throw away your confidence. It will be richly rewarded. You need to persevere so that when you have done the will of God, you receive what He has promised.
Amen.
For in just a very little while, He who is coming will come and will not delay. But my righteous one will live by faith. And if he shrinks back, I will not be pleased with him. But we are not of those who shrink back and are destroyed. Hallelujah. But of those who believe and are saved. Hallelujah. You can all be seated. The first step for you having a miracle is you have to believe. You have to put your confidence in God. You got to be a person that lives a faith atmosphere that you believe that God has something for you.
Amen.
And please, you are not a product of an explosion.
Amen.
The big militarily doesn't exist. You are someone created by God, and God has something for you.
Yeah.
God has something for you. Before you even were born, God has already planted something for you.
Yeah.
And one thing is this. If you believe, you're going to get the gift from the Lord.
Amen.
If you believe, you're going to get your reward. You're going to be rewarded from the Lord. And this is something that sometimes we miss this point. Because of troubles in life, because of something that happens that we don't want to happen, or something that we are not expecting, it's like our faith goes down. Our faith gets weak. I'm here, and I was sent by God from Brazil to tell you, please, when trouble comes, believe God will help you with all troubles. When you face troubles or you face problems, this is our Holy Ghost testing us faith.
Yeah.
Our faith needs to be tested because God needs to know from our heart that we are believing in Him. If you talked with me 2 months ago, are you going to the United States, River of Life Worship Center? I will tell you, I don't know. I wish I would go, but I didn't know. But the time I put my faith in the Lord and said, I'm going, the door will open. The door will open. I remember a friend of mine, Pastor Lally knows, Pastor Bobby knows, Arthur. From our church, the guitar player. He was our worship team leader. He had two kids, and he would like to, back at that time ago, he wished to have a daughter. And God gave him a daughter. But when she was born, she had a blood problem. And I remember that I was, back at that time, I used to live in the apartment near downtown. You've been there. I think it was 06 or 07. And I remember that day that he came into me and said, El Pastor Junior, my daughter Sarah, she's in the hospital, and what the doctor says is that her problem is impossible. She has a blood problem, and I don't know what I'm going to do. I told him, by faith, you asked the daughter from God, right? Yeah. Do you believe that he gave you this daughter? He said, yes. Well, I asked him a daughter. My wife couldn't have a daughter, but he gave a daughter. He said, so, your daughter belongs to Jesus, not to the hospital.
Amen.
Stop praying, because you're going to receive your daughter back. And then when he would go to the hospital, and all the doctors, they would say something that was not what he was expecting. They would say that there was no hope for Sarah. But inside of his heart, the doctor of doctors, Jesus Christ, he knew for sure that he would get his sick daughter out of the hospital. Do you know what happened? She's a big girl about this size. She didn't die because Jesus Christ saved her from that disease. Because he believed. Because he believed. Sometimes we're Christians, we're put in some situations that we kind of lose our confidence. We lose the act of believing. And what's the result if we don't believe? The result that we have if we don't believe is that we're going to lose the blessing of the Lord. We need to exercise our faith. We need to put our faith into action. Every single thing we do, simple things, big things, whatever. If you have a headache, pray in the name of Jesus before you take aspirin. But you need to exercise your faith so that in the academy of faith, God will make your faith stronger day by day if you exercise. And don't accept, never in your life, that you don't trust that God can do anything. God can do anything. He's able to do any possible thing if you believe. And this is in the Bible over here. You need to persevere. Well, persevere is to keep up doing things that God wants you to do. In the way that we live life nowadays, this is not only in the United States, but in Brazil. We have our desires. We have the things we love to do. We have the things we love deeply doing. But my question is, are the things you like to do, do they really honor Jesus? The things that you like to do are things that Jesus is happy about your doing. There is a very, you know, there is a space. And this is something that we got to focus, Christians, nowadays. We got to do the will of God. Because even though we do things that make us happy, the will of the Lord will make us happier. God's dreams is bigger than our dreams. God, you know, when he dreams about you, and I tell you something, you have someone, please, man, please, lady, you have someone that is in love with you deeply. His name is Jesus. And he dreams with you all the time. He thinks about you. When he sees you in the morning, he sees you in the daytime, he sees you during the night. Jesus loves you in such a way that he sees you every single day and he has great expectations from you. He expects you to give your best for him. The miracles comes when we give our best to Jesus. And the, our best is just a simple thing. We gotta believe that Jesus is able to do things through us. Hey, the angels of heaven would like to do things that we do. One of them is to preach the gospel. But we are in charge of this because God put us in this position. The angels of heaven would like to have a lot of things, and I'm sure that we do, but God gave this to us. Do you know why? The relationship between God and the angels are very different than our relationship. Our relationship with Jesus and the Father and the Holy Ghost is a family relationship. It's in a deep way. So what God really wants from us is a deep relationship with the Lord. And what is this deep relationship with the Lord? I see Christians in Brazil, they start going to church and then they give up. I see people in Brazil start going to church and start building their faith, but something happens, or he gets upset with someone in the church, or he has a problem. Oh, it's very hard to forgive that sister. It's very hard to forgive that brother. Oh, he touched me in a way that I didn't like. He said something I didn't like. And then they throw away the main and the most important gift that we have, that our faith in Jesus. Look, the enemy knows that. When you lose the desire of coming to the church, or you lose the desire of have fellowship with your brother or sister, the devil begins to win and to overcome upon you. And you're going to lose faith And when you lose faith, you lose your focus. And when you lose your focus, you'll be defeated very soon by the devil. You stay weak, your family will stay weak, and the devil will conquer over you. But tonight, you're going to receive a new anointing. The anointing of the Lord that you're going to overcome any kind of problem. And I'm sure that God will take you to a better place, which you're going to receive the high power of our Lord, and the Holy Ghost will help you to find a way to your miracle to come. There's something over here that it's a name that the Lord in verse 38 calls us, the righteous one. The righteous one, it means that you've been justified by Jesus Christ. The righteous one is an expression that it means that the blood of our Christ Savior has cleaned you and made you not condemned, but saved you from sin. The righteous one, it's a name that is for us. It's a wonderful name given by Jesus that it means that you are being saved by Him.
Yes.
You know what's the problem with our enemy? In Revelation chapter 20, verse 10, he's already condemned. He had already his condemnation. But you're free because of Jesus. The devil knows that he's going to be in hell for eternity, but Jesus Christ, he saved you, amen, and you're going to be with him for eternity. But one thing's for sure, the one that came to steal, to rob, and to destroy, he wants to steal your salvation. He wants to steal your life with Jesus. Now, you're going to face your enemy. You're going to say, I'm the righteous one, and from now on, I'm going to live by faith.
Yeah.
You know what's live by faith? You know what's live by faith? Is expect a miracle day by day.
Amen.
Do you know what is live by faith? Every single day when you wake up, before you go to work, you have this assurance inside of you. Your confidence that God will open the doors for you.
Amen.
Like God did to Moses, he opened the Red Sea. He's opening our Red Seas in our lives.
Amen.
Like God did to Apostle Paul and Silas when they were arrested. Hallelujah. God is going to set you free from any kind of prison you have. God is able. And I'm telling you, like the word said in Hebrew, Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and ever. He's the same Jesus that used to do a lot of miracles in the past. Today, he's doing the same thing in Brazil, in America. Jesus is here to make you go to another step, river of life. But please, never give up your faith. Your faith is like a house that you build day by day. Unfortunately, most of your houses over here, they are not made of bricks. In Brazil, all of them are made of bricks and cement. And it's very, very easy to illustrate this. You put the brick, and it's our houses are slower to build, because they're very difficult, because you gotta wait to the cement and have this iron structure and then the bricks structure. Our faith is like that house. Every single day, you're gonna work on a detail on your life. Every single day, you gotta put another brick in your day, another brick in your life, and let our Dr. Jesus work in a deeply way for us to become more Jesus. You are someone and you look like Jesus, or you should look like Jesus, and you're going to work inside of you to look like Jesus. Look to your neighbor next to you. See, he looks like Jesus. He's a Jesus guy. He's a Jesus girl. Yes, you look like Jesus. You have a Jesus smile. You have a Jesus hug. You are a Jesus creature. Hallelujah. 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 The enemy wants to take your Jesus appearance out. The enemy wants to take the Jesus characteristics on you. He wants to take it out. When we started, and I seems like, you know, in Brazil, You know, fast food is very famous in the United States, but it's becoming very famous in the United in Brazil too. And I see some Christians, they are like fast food, you know? They want everything to be instantaneous. They don't want to have their faith working. They don't want to establish, hey, there's a time. I wanted to be over here at River 7 years ago, but there's a time. And even though I think that, oh, God delayed, He's right in the right time. God shows up in the right time. God's time is God's time, and it's a better time than our time. Oh, Pastor, I need the miracle today. Okay, you're going to ask the miracle today. But when it comes, it's the time for a miracle. It's God's time. Oh, if you, how about if the miracle doesn't come today? You're going to wait. Never lose faith. Don't forget faith. Don't forget to build your faith day by day by trusting, believing, and offering yourself to Jesus. But I tell you, He's going to show up. God is going to show up in the right time. In the right time. There was a girl. I used to teach English at a Internexus, Yazzie Internexus school back in my city. And there was a very a rich family, and they had two daughters. And one daughter was my student. And I remember one day that God used me because I was giving a class, and all of a sudden this girl came inside of the class, and she said, well, I don't know what's bringing me here, but I'm here to tell you that I'm going to kill myself right now. And I remember that she was an 18-year-old girl. She had just started her law school class. And I said, why you want to, her name was Emanuela. And I said, hey, Emanuela, why do you want to kill yourself? And then she started speaking about her life. And all of a sudden, I was, imagine, you are giving a class, and then someone comes up and says, I'm going to kill myself in front of your students. So everybody got crazy, and I had to put the class to do an exercise and hold her a little bit. I was kind of pastor and kind of professor and kind of everything. And I said, Jesus Christ, what am I going to do? And I, like in schools here, schools there, you cannot talk about religion also. And I said, what am I going to do right now? And then I started talking with that girl. And I was praying for her. And then all of a sudden, she got possessed. And I was giving English class. Praise the Lord, it was English for beginners. My students thought that she was speaking in English, but she was speaking other tongues. And I said, hey, just be quiet. I'm going to get my English class, and then I come back. And the devil starts, you know, telling some bad names on me, but praise the Lord, it was not in Portuguese. And then I prayed for that girl, and she didn't commit suicide. She received the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And this is how we build faith.
Yes.
Amen.
Back in Jerusalem 4 in 1997, I was with the Southern Baptists. I'm not against Southern Baptists. I love them, and I had my time there. It was wonderful. But I was there. And then all of a sudden, a guy got possessed too. And then the pastor that was with me, he said, hey, Junior, translate what the guy's saying. And I said, there's no translation about that, man. Just a problem. So I was like, well, what is it? Well, a creature from out of town. Hey, you know something? Stronger lives inside of you. I like when demons shows up. You know why? Because my Jesus is Lord. The demons come to make us human beings to suffer, but Jesus come to set them free. And this is the Jesus I believe. This is the living God that I believe. This is the living God that I believe. Hey, church, we need to serve a Lord, and we're here to serve a Lord, but we need to have the fun time with the Lord. And what is fun about Jesus expelling demons? It's fun. It's action. Right, Brother Ron? It's superhero. My Jesus is a superhero. Hallelujah. Every Christian should have this experience. Once, Serge and I, you know, my grandpa, my father too, they put us a nickname, Ghostbusters. Yes, we were the Ghostbusters. Because we've been baptized with the Holy Ghost and have all those good things, speaking tongues, and oh man, it's good. And we would like wake up at 2 a.m. in the morning and get out in the streets. In Valadares, expelling some demons, drug addictions, prostitutes, and said, yo, in the name of Jesus, do you want to receive prayer? Imagine, two boys in the middle of the night, do you want to receive a Jesus prayer? Okay. Cast away some, no, this is experience. This is experience. This is experience. Pastor Bobby, he'd been to Turmalina. In a voodoo place, in a voodoo territory.
Yes.
And now, just for God's glory, that voodoo place, now it's a Christian church. It's a Christian church. Do you know why? Because he let the Holy Ghost exercise his faith.
That's right.
Hey, everybody over here, you have a desire to be the best you can. Who has this desire? Please. Be the best Christian as you can.
Yes.
God wants to make you the best Christian as you can. And how can you develop this? Exercise faith. How can you develop this? Well, open your heart for the Holy Ghost. How can you exercise this? Being the righteous one, living by faith. And how can you exercise this? Hey, please, headaches are the beginning. I have a headache. Let me pray for you. Some people, they just take aspirin right away. I don't mean that medication is bad. No, medication is good. God gave intelligence for the man to produce medication. God gave intelligence for the man to become doctors. Praise the Lord. But have the habit to exercise faith.
Yes.
Have the habit to exercise faith. Sometimes, and please, church, open your heart for this. Sometimes you feel overwhelmed, depressed. This is not something just body, just because you're sick. It's a spiritual influence. Here in Port Vincent, I'm from Brazil. I know that the spiritual atmosphere from the south of the USA is kind of hard. You guys have a lot of voodoo background back here.
Yeah.
It's like you go to Bahia. And south of Brazil, Porto Alegre, is the place that the voodoo in Brazil is stronger. When you go there, some cities in Brazil, if you go by, you feel sick because of the strongholds.
Yeah, right.
And you know something? God gave you ears for you to listen, but he gave us also spiritual ears for you to listen. God gave you sight, but he gave you spiritual eyes. You got to exercise this. People that, like in the end of this text over here, shrinks back. Oh no, this is too Pentecostal for me. Okay, I want Jesus. I want this nice worship songs, but please, I just want the three steps for salvation. Lord, I just want meeting. You have the beginners, intermediate, and advanced. I want to stop at my intermediate Christian course. I don't want the advance. Hey, please, church. Who wants to go to heaven over here? Only advanced people go to heaven. Let's go, people! Let's share faith. Share faith. Let's pray for everyone. Let's pray. Even old Pastor Bob, it didn't happen anything. Well, don't worry. The next one you pray will happen. You gotta have this great expectation that God is gonna use you in such a way that his glory will fall down in this earth. Hallelujah. The glory of God is here. The glory of God is in your life. You got to spread it. You got to let it go. You got to give yourself a chance to be a vessel of God, that God will use you. God will use you. I remember a friend of mine. He was my age. And I remember he had a problem. He had a lot of girlfriends. And he had a lot of involvement with a lot of women. And his cell phone was 100 names of women. But look at this. He came to me and said, "Hey, Junior, I want to get away from this life. I want Jesus. I want Jesus." And then the telephone rang. Was another one. Said, "Junior, I'm not going to ring this one." I said, "Okay, but let's do something. Let's pray. In each name, you're going to say, I don't want this in the name of Jesus." And I got his cell phone. Name by name, he would say the name and said, "I don't want this anymore in the name of Jesus. I want to be set free. I want to be set free. I want to be set free." At the end of this telephone names that we erased, he was baptized with the Holy Ghost. But he had the guts to decide that he wanted Jesus. Sometimes some people need you to be their helper for them to have the guts to make a decision. We are like bridges to connect people to God. We gotta think this way. Some people just need a push. And we, as the vessels of the Lord, we're there to push them or to pull them. We're there to make the difference because we are the righteous ones. But please, church, never in your life shrink back your decisions to serve the Lord.
Right.
Never shrink back to be what God wants you to be. The decisions we made in life, they can't change the future generations that we have on. You're over here, but you don't represent not just yourself. You represent your grandchildren in the future. And please, if you let the Holy Ghost use you in just this generation, I'm sure that the Lord is gonna do a great work.
Hallelujah.
In your life, and it's gonna change the generations and generations and generations and generations. Have you ever listened or have you ever heard about Hossein? Is an Islam in Rio, is the biggest Islam in South America. I remember I was 20 years old, and I went there. My father and my mother got a little bit worried because they thought I would never come back. There was a Christian church there. Lolly went there. And I remember I went there because there was a pastor. And this pastor, he was about 85 years old. And I was just a 20-year-old boy. And I've heard that brother, he had a gift. He had a gift given by the Lord to teach about spiritual warfare. And I said, "Well, this man has a church in Hossein. It's the biggest slum in South America. Has all the drug dealers you can think in all the world that they run there, they rule there. And it's difficult to get there." And I stayed some days with him. And I remember something that it will never forget. The drug dealers, when he was crossing those little streets, because they were so tiny, and there was a drug dealer with a handgun, with a machine gun in his hand, the demon would manifest, but it would manifest like this: "I cannot do anything with this man. I can't do anything with this man." And it was really interesting because this pastor, his name was Almir, he's with the Lord now. Every time that he touched the man, the demons would let the man get out of him, and they were set free by the power of Jesus. Mm-hmm. All his church members, they used to be drug dealers.
Wow.
I remember a day at his church that a drug dealer came. And he was with a machine gun, and all of a sudden something stopped him in the doors, church. And he let the machine gun down on the floor, and he came down on his knees saying, I accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior. You know what, something? Every time that God does a miraculous thing in people's life, in our community, this impacts people.
Amen.
A drug dealing Rocinha to accept Christ, it's a miracle, impacts the community. This church, and I'm sure by faith, it's gonna happen a lot of miracles to impact the community so that the people will come over here.
Yes.
Miracle brings people to the church.
Yes.
Manifestation of the Lord brings people to the church because the people wants to be set free.
Yes.
Depression, I know it's a big problem in America. It's a big problem in Brazil too. But this world that is sick, that is dying out there, they need the word from the church. There's life over here.
Yeah.
There's life over here.
Yeah.
Jesus can heal your depression.
Yeah.
Jesus can heal your disease. And please, church, God has you to tell the word about that.
Yeah.
Can you please stand on your feet?